There's going to come a time when people are going to say what? La ilaha illallah. And then one person is going to hear him and say, yeah, you know what? I heard that word before. I heard La ilaha illallah before. My forefathers used to say something like that. Didn't the Prophet say that's going to happen? Didn't the Prophet say that's going to happen? What is the thing that every Muslim should know? Why would it happen there would come a time when La ilaha illallah is unknown to the people? How did that happen? It will only happen if the Muslim du'at, this is what's making it happen. The du'at are going to say to the people, well, everyone knows La ilaha illallah, there's no need to speak about it. And so they speak about other issues. They tackle political issues. They only speak about other issues. La ilaha illallah, comes a generation who's never heard of it. Because no one spoke about it, right? Everybody was assuming that every Muslim should know it. They don't know what La ilaha illallah means. Rather, if you go to YouTube today, there's a video of a guy who asks people, قُلْ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدْ, can you read it? And they can't read it. Have you seen it? Muslims in Muslim world countries, in Arab countries, are being asked basic Islamic questions. Muhammad ibn, the Prophet's name, they can't finish off. Wallahi, is on YouTube. I'll send it to you guys. Basic Islamic questions are being asked. I'll give you an example. I ask you brothers right now, and sisters, بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, who can tell me what أَشَدَّ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولَ, what it means? What does it mean, wa shahadana Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? See how serious it is? Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. You guys say ashhadu la ilaha illallah and you say ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. What is wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah? When you testify that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, what do you mean? What do you say? What are you saying? Who can say it to me in Arabic? Yeah? Ta'atu fi ma amar. Wa tasdiqu fi ma akhbar. وَاجْتِنَابُهُ مَا نَهَا عَنْ وَزَجَرُ وَأَلَّا يُعْبَدَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِمَا شَرَعَ, and that Allah is not worshipped. Those are the four things. Every single one of you here, that's what it means when you say Shaddam Hamza. Those four points is what you're agreeing to. You're testifying. If you don't know those four, then Shaddam Muhammad Rasulullah is a mujarradil alfab. It's just a mere letter that you're uttering. What does it mean to you? صح? هَيَوْ وَأَشَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. What does that mean? Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, what does it mean? La ma'buda bi haqqin illallah. Where did you bring the word haqq from? I'm talking to you. La ma'buda bi haqqin illallah. That Allah is the one who's rightfully deserving to be worshipped. And where did you bring the word haqq from? I'm not moving away from except la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. But where? What's the evidence? Evidence is qala Allah, qala Rasul. Hey? Hey? Yeah? Just the deen, I want Allah. It does fall under there, but I want a more apparent, more direct verse. Well, you said, La ma'buda bihaqin, haq, haq. Use the word haq. Where did you bring the word haq from? Who gave it to you? Why are you using the word haq? Do you see how the matter, I'm trying to show you something, brothers. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ هُوَ الْبَاطِلِ. That's the verse. But do you see the problem? Just studying La ilaha illallah. What does it mean? What does it actually mean?